Okay, in this episode, we're going to talk about climbing. You've been climbing for a lot of years, and there's only three things you really need to know. Number one, anybody can get into climbing because they have really easy climbing and really hard climbing, so obviously you start with the easy climbing. Number two, there's two very popular types of climbing that you'll see. In this gym today, you're going to see bouldering, which means we're climbing without any ropes or harnesses. And the other climbing is top roping, where you wear a harness, you tie in, and you have someone on the opposite end of the rope belaying you, holding your weight in case you fall. And the third thing is that the gear for climbing is really cheap. You're not going to need to spend thousands of dollars to get into this sport. You're going to need to get a pair of shoes and maybe a harness and maybe some chalk. So let's show you a little bit about climbing. Since this gym is all bouldering, you're not going to see any top roping here. You'll see top roping later in the video, but top roping is when the rope runs up through some kind of pulley system and back down. It would be tied into your harness and someone else will belay you. If you go to a gym that has top roping, they're gonna make you go through some sort of training. It will take you 30 minutes to an hour for them to train you up on how to properly belay someone, and you have to do it or they won't let you do it. So when it comes to bouldering, the routes are labeled V0, V1, V2, V3, and up. Basically, your VB is beginners, V0 is easy, V1 and 2 intermediate, and V3s I find nearly impossible. But come over here and look. This is a VB, beginner. This is a V0, also pretty much beginner. This is essentially a ladder. You just climb up it. And the same with the V0s. Now, come with me. This is a V2, which I often have difficulty with, and I probably will not be able to climb this. In fact, sometimes I can't even get on the wall.
So my shoes are extra small. You typically get a size like smaller than your foot so that you can fit snug in it without coming out. And then they're pointed. My shoes come in handy here because I can get on very small holds.
So this is a V1, but when you start, there's a certain maneuver called a dyno, which means you have to get from here to that hold. And as you can see, there's no holds in between. This is my favorite thing to do. Maggie doesn't really like this, but I think it's a lot of fun. And what you saw me do there with my leg is called flagging. I'm doing that because if you saw, I had a lot of my weight to the right and I needed to have some counterweight on the left. That's why I did that. Did I do it on the left? I meant to the right. I flagged to the right, so my weight had to go left. You do that sometimes. Just like a ballerina. So if you do yoga, you'll probably be really good at climbing. Really recommend you get out and go climb an actual rock wall, because that's where you'll have a lot of fun. As we did in California, take a look. So unfortunately, when you're climbing, the routes are not labeled necessarily on the mountain. So we just sent Allie up what we thought was a 5'7".
5'11".
It was actually a 5'11". She got about a quarter of the way up and determined that it seemed really difficult for a 5'7". So Maggie and I went and referenced the binder, not a 5'7". So Matt's gonna take a swing at it. I'm not. I'm just gonna eat jerky.
So this is top roping. We rappel down on the blue rope and then all we do is just climb back up and clean the rope. Okay, so this route's like a 5'11" and it's pretty slick. There's not a ton to grab onto and it looks pretty gnarly at the top because it's slopey and slick. But the bottom, it's just like these little tiny crimps and a little...
So just so you've got some of the lingo down, holds like these. They'll call them, this is almost like, they're called a jug, almost because it's like a milk jug, because you can really grab it. Something like this, if you try to grab this with your hands, they'll call this a crimper grip. And I really hate these, they're really hard to do. But the more expert climbers don't have a problem with them.
All right, right now I'm making my figure eight knot. That's what keeps me safe when I climb. It's called a figure eight because it's a figure eight. You can see it's figure eight by the way that it is. And I'm gonna put that right through my harness. I'm just gonna trace it back, make it nice and pretty. I'm gonna finish it with a nice safety knot, also known as a fisherman's knot. And I'm gonna just scurry my way up this here cliff. Oh, nice, nice, nice. This is an ATC. This is my harness. These are my shoes. My nice, pretty shoes.
This hoagie? Yeah.
I just eat my sandwich.
Just a little snack before the climb.
Can I get a bite of that?
Yeah, have some sandwich.
Too busy, eating a sandwich. People are going to think we're climbing drunk based on that little gear rundown you just gave me. Guys, that's it. That is climbing in a nutshell. Really hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. And stay tuned because we'll be having plenty more travel and adventure to come.